Can everybody hear me?
Yes, ma'am.
Dear America, here's an open letter with a bold header that can never describe how my lineage has been traumatized, ridiculed, and criticized through this systematic structure intended to break us. Evidently, from education to the penitentiary, they tell us this is our history and statistically meant to be. Only three teachers truly believed in me in elementary. I was undefined while the rest gradually tried to undermine my intelligence and standardize my abilities, telling me all of my incapabilities, like high threes made him more intelligent than me, and placed us in a class hierarchy based on these standardized categories. My eighth grade teacher told me I was the best reader but couldn't write, while my high school teachers defied all of those lies. Breezed through like a snippet or a preview. I went against the grain of what they thought I couldn't be. Astonished when I came back with a degree, and technically, since I'm pretty darn good at IT, they're also paying me. Cop car sirens play in the back of black boys through their rearview mirror. Unequipped for the interrogated convo, so they gear up. Bodies still like stillborn babies. The intensities from these young men is undoubtedly crazy, because they never know what's going to go down when you've been taught that America profoundly values the traditional custom of being racially profiled, while they're just trying to clear out the distortion of why society annihilates us and uses for extortion, like an unborn fetus suffering from abortion, gasping for air like justice. It's just this reluctance to believe that the system is fair and for us when we've been strangled, dangled, and captured by America's chokehold, from the noose to Fox News, constantly ridiculing our brothers, telling us they can never make it past 22. So these young boys turn into men fueled with animosity from the burden of brutality, reaping silent repercussions like intentional concussions. Mental health for these brothers and mothers are beyond discussions. So we learn to deal with our fears and sorrow through our own coping mechanisms, trying to ignore how society belittles our children and prep our young boys for these issues. But how can we, when we never know if that's the last time your mother will ever kiss you? Lips pressed against warm skin and energy, a promising future shot down because the system doesn't believe. These stories are untold, but these lies will never be unknown. Eric Garner, Trayvon Martin, Sean Bell, Amadou Diallo, Emmett Till. Until the face of justice reveals and heals the scars from the pain, our hearts will forever fight for your names. We will sing about you. And to my brothers and sisters who feel like the world is on your shoulders like boulders, on cloudy days, it's the sun you can't see through. I believe in you. Never get discouraged from the blessings that people try to block, because the only thing you cannot do is stop. Follow your dreams.